Okay. So here are five bridges that should be built. So
we're not gonna talk about five bridges that should be built. We're gonna talk about why there should be a bridge directly connecting Massachusetts to Maine. So if anyone knows, there's a very small 15-ish mile or 24-ish kilometer corridor that separates Massachusetts from Maine as a part of New Hampshire. This gives New Hampshire coastal access. But what if there's a bridge or tunnel that directly connected them through the Atlantic Ocean?
Now, a Massachusetts Maine
bridge or tunnel has never been seriously proposed. But I'm going to tell you why it should be. So obviously, we can't just have it directly off the coast. That would just be too bad, even for a tunnel. We'd have to build it a little bit more significantly out. We're not talking, say, Boston to, like, Portland. Actually, because of the way the coast works, I believe
that
the Massachusetts coast comes back in. That's why it might be great to build a Cape Cod Boston bridge.
It could be on US
Route 6 and connect it out to US Route 20 in Boston. They connect, they really only connect at some remote, in Cleveland and other points in Sandusky, Ohio, where 6 is actually briefly above 20. Though they get close in northern Indiana, Chicago metro area, at Erie, Pennsylvania, and a lot of other points. But this would be an official connection and would be good for US 6.
As
to route numberings, I suggest that this be an auxiliary interstate 95. Now, in Massachusetts, Maine is actually a nice connection. Like, there's an interstate 195, 295, 395, and 495. But I'm not too sure about how Maine works. I don't think any auxiliaries go from New Hampshire into Maine. But I know that interstate 195 and 295 in Massachusetts come from Rhode Island, and 395 comes from Connecticut. So yes, this would definitely ruin that that great sense of, because it won't be an interstate 595. That's generally a spur. For example, it would be an interstate 595 if the road came from somewhere in New Hampshire.
For example, interstate
395 is a spur, and 295 isn't. I don't know if 295 connects back to 95 again at Massachusetts, but I do know that 195 is a spur into the southeastern part of Massachusetts, and 395 is actually a spur because 195 doesn't connect to Massachusetts. It's actually a spur up to interstate 90 at Auburn, Massachusetts. So essentially, to connect to central Massachusetts. Some spurs are significant. Interstate 55 is in the state of Tennessee.
It is in the U.S. state of Tennessee. And so is 155.
But 155 acts as a spur, as it doesn't connect in Memphis, but it actually connects in eastern Arkansas. And then it goes across the Interstate 155 bridge, concurrent with US 412, into Tennessee.
So,
So it'll probably be Interstate 695, and it would. tri-state interstate, and it would kind of be a bypass of Portsmouth, but an ocean bypass. It would be a huge bridge. There are some problems with that, though. Most notably the fact that it wouldn't be good to just have an auxiliary as one of those. It probably wouldn't be good form. Therefore, it's probably best if there's a little bit of expressway on both ends and the bridge takes up most of it and not all of it.
Oh yeah, Interstate
555 is also a spa. It's
spa.
From somewhere only 14 miles away from Memphis, Tennessee, out to Jonesboro, Arkansas. I mean, Interstate 57, I guess, could be a bypass of Interstate 55 and auxiliary, but it's way too long to be one. It's like a really big bypass. Like, I mean, it doesn't directly connect back to 55, though, and that's the thing. Like, you wonder, for interstate bypass, aren't they supposed to, like, be a bypass? Yes, but also, that's close enough. They end just within 10 miles or 16 kilometers of each other, therefore making them reasonably close enough.
They're close enough.
I mean, that's so close enough to the extent that, I don't know. It connects to Interstate 55 and Second Summit Zone, and you get close in Chicago to both 57 Termini, but 55 ends just a little further north. That, you take 57 and 94. It's actually more direct route, and that's generally what auxiliaries are. Interstate 495 in New York actually was supposed to be connected to 90, it used to connect to 95 in Weehawken prior to 1970, and then briefly again from 1982 to 1985. Before it was transducted back to, back out to Long Island City, and now it's Murray Hill, both of which are in New York. There was also a plan for a Long Island Sound Tunnel. Here's the thing. A lot of these, the way it worked is Long Island Community is approved of it because they didn't want to go on a throgs like bridge and pay a toll. The Connecticut communities on the other side didn't want it, but obviously the communities on Long Island had more support. The governor of New York let New York City vote. Basically, everyone in New York City voted no, except for the people in Richmond County, but that's a whole other story not being covered in this video. And then, due to all the sway of New York City votes, it doesn't happen. The 2018 one that was supposed to go expand 135 out to Oyster Bay, and then connect that to Rye, New York, at Interstate 287. Was the first one that saw a substantial Long Island oppose. Because the communities in Connecticut are obviously still fetched against it, but this time they didn't go to a vote. Because what happened in past was, even though Connecticut was dead set against it, there was enough Long Island support to make a vote feasible. But this time, most of Long Island opposed it, as in prior experiences, there was already a road there that they could supersede, use, so it wouldn't split up their communities.
There's a reason why 135 was
never expanded, because it just barged through too many communities. So while Syosset and Woodbury mutually approved of it, no other hamlet or village has approved of it.
Anyway, so
now we're going to end on what do I think that NY-135 exits past exit 1 and 14 will be. So first of all, let me just say that that Merrick Road wouldn't be exit one if it were expanded. It would either be expanded to Ocean Parkway, the one, or State Parkway. Both of which would become the new exit one, and Merrick Road would probably be exit two.
As for
135, the northern exit, which we're assuming now NY25, is still assuming it's exit 14, even though it would really be 15.
God
damn it.
I don't know. Because here's the thing.
Like until it gets, like, Boundary Avenue, they're all significant enough to, like, want exits. Like, I wouldn't remove any exits until exit 6. So maybe 24, so maybe all the exits would be exit 6. But then at 24, it'd stay exit 7. Because, like, here's the thing. And Merrick Road is obviously a very busy road. 27 is 2, so Merrick Road is exit 2, and 27 is exit 23. The SSP, NY105 at only 5.5 kilometers or 3.4 miles, you might argue it is, but because it goes to Belmore and the first direct connector between 106 and 107, which at this point are fairly far apart, and just the fact of how long, if it only began at Warner Avenue, I'd say support, but otherwise just oppose. I don't know, maybe it would be like an exit 1A thing, so it won't serve the exits, but anyway, I'd say Covenant Road might be exit 15. And 135 is kind of split on the issue of, well, what about these? Because it's really not unanimous. I'd say exit 16 would probably be Syosset Woodbury Road. Exit 17 would probably be NY25A. Exit
18
would probably be NY106, where I would then enter into the tunnel. But here's the thing, I don't think that any of that is realistic at all, because there's not enough support to have even 135 barge through the communities. I mean, if you think about it, Long Island Sound Tunnel obviously doesn't have much support, and there's also never been any support for 135 to be extended even without a bridge or tunnel, and I think that's where most of the Long Island opposition came from. There isn't a great place to just build one of these. I think that one of the best places would be out at Orient, where they could just expand NY25. And there are a lot of construction projects that people want first. So you know Suffolk County has 10 towns? Well, so you have Huntington and Babylon. Then Simiton and Islip, which, by the way, if you're wondering, they're basically, like, due north-south of each other, but I don't know if Huntington borders Islip, maybe Simiton borders Babylon, I'm not sure, I'll look that up. And then you have Brookhaven, which is, like, a slab, so you have to go through Brookhaven. There's, like, no other alternative.
Also,
I'd say that once you pass Smithtown and get to Brookhaven, I'd say that somewhere in Smithtown and Islip, probably somewhere around the Jake's 58 Casino, maybe a little farther out, definitely like NY12 at the eastest most point is the eastern bound, is the middle point of Long Island, but I'd say Riverhead is next, so obviously you have Riverhead, which below that I'd say is Southampton, but I'm not even sure if Southampton even borders Brookhaven.
Like, I wouldn't even be
sure of that.
Hempstead, as for, know, has like Southampton.
Which actually, the distance between my house and South Haven is only slightly longer than between Southampton and East Hampton. West Hampton and East Hampton, but Southampton's a town and East Hampton is, which is Southhold and then Real Shelter Island. So obviously MI-114 connects the two, but you have to take two ferries. It's also the only New York State route, I think, in the series that goes in three towns. So 101 is entirely North Hempstead, 102 is entirely Hempstead, 103 is out in Centennial County, 104 is on a complete other side of the state, 105 is, I think, in North Hempstead, Hempstead and Oyster Bay, 106, I think, is in Hempstead and Oyster Bay, 107, I think, is only in Oyster Bay, though it's possible it's in Hempstead.
I know, because, like, the way it works is
super weird, so, like, Warner Avenue, then immediately after Central Park Avenue, or Central Avenue, and immediately after that, it seems like it should be South Oyster Bay Road, and this road becomes South Broadway. But it's actually not. It's actually the Grumman's Road, which connects back to Hazel Street, which you have to come back out to, and I really wish that there was a direct connection in the South Oyster Bay Road, also, I suppose. It's super confusing down there. Like, without a map, I can't show you, so it's probably going to be something
I'm going to stream. Probably something that but as for
108 is entirely, well, actually 108 is on the border between Oyster Bay and Huntington, it's on the Woodbury West Hills border, Cold Spring Harbor, and then it goes back into Cold Spring Harbor, so it actually begins at the Nassau County boundary. 109 is in Oyster Bay, and then Babylon, but it doesn't go into Melville there, because it doesn't go into Melville. Because of that,
because it doesn't go into Melville,
it actually goes into,
So
it doesn't go into Huntington, which is sad. 110 is in Huntington and Babylon. It's really close to Oyster Bay, down by the DSSP, but unfortunately, it doesn't make it, though. 111, I think, is Smithtown and Islip. 112 is just Brookhaven. 113, I think, is up in Dutchess County. And 114, yeah, it's the only one in three.